there she was, casual, direct, thoughtful, sweet, saying, you know, I see what you're doing on Arista with Dion. She said, for years, I had that relationship with Jerry Wexler. I really need a partner again. I really need someone who I feel can understand me, who can represent me to the best songwriters all over the world.
I said, well, what do you do? How do you live your life? Oh, maybe I'll go out to a club. Maybe I'll see somebody at the club I like. He may look at me, I may look at him. It's the feeling of who's zooming who. I'm writing this down, who's zooming who. You know, he looks at me, I look at him. He thinks he's got me, right? But then the fish jumps off the hook. I'm like, the fish jumps off the hook. That becomes the chorus of who's zooming who. That's how she talks. I don't know if people know that. She's on a different planet. She's really, really hip, streetwise, and yet sincerely gospel.
Electrifying.
Inspirational.
She really is the queen of soul.
Not as long as she's around and singing will anybody else be given that title.
Who's better?
The heart is where she's coming from.
She's an absolute boss lady.
She was born to sing and play. She was born to do what she does.
She's definitely a star, every inch a star.
Always number one.
Over every woman that sings, she is the queen.
She will always be the queen of soul. And the legacy will be, was it her, Streisand, or Callas, the female voice of the 20th century?
There's no one higher, greater, more musically in touch with God than Aretha Franklin. And I think the whole world knows that. That's why we call her the queen of soul. Now, you can go to Stevie Wonder, you can go to Ray Charles, you can go to all those great people, Donny Hathaway, and there's a bunch. But she is our queen. She is our queen.